Energy diplomacy, so there's the focus on where energy is really a proxy for other foreign policy issues. So as we know, energy is not just about BTUs or barrels. It's also the lifeblood of an economy. It provides for development, it provides the necessary input for human capital, and especially for the region, it is a bedrock of political stability. We want to see reliable, affordable energy. And so that's where we work. Firstly, I was in, this is my first time in this capacity, in official capacity in this role. And Africa is such a critical place in terms of the broader energy diplomacy story. Africa represents some of the fastest growing economies in the world. It is the catalyst for a lot of the growth, as the world will require 50% more energy in 2040 than we produce today. And some of that drive is coming from the continent. So firstly, it's an important place for energy supplies, but it's also an important location for some of the new energy types, which are requiring new forms of minerals. Africa has abundant mineral sources. And so we thought it was appropriate time for me to come here, particularly as we were launching new initiatives, as Africa seeks to develop its own energy pathway, but also Africa has a critical role to play in providing the world with the energy it needs. Yes, we are very pleased that Botswana has taken part in a new initiative that we've launched called the Energy Resources Governance Initiative, or ERGI. ERGI puts together a collection of some of the world's leading resource developers: United States, Canada, Australia, Peru, and on this continent, Botswana. These are all countries that have demonstrated over the long term best practice for minerals development. Together, we hope to understand very different cultures, different regulatory environments, different histories. But we've all, in our own ways, have adopted best practice. We believe, working together, we can show the world what international best practice is. We want to make sure that countries, through the construct of ERGI, countries around the world will be able to develop their own resources to help their own economies, but also to provide supplies to the rest of the world as well. We're going to see an increasing picking and choosing of who's a preferred responsible play, who is a responsible provider of minerals. All countries aspire to be, but some frankly lack the capacity. So by having this multi-country initiative, of which Botswana is a critical part, we intend to identify what best practice is, but also to give them the capacity and the tools to actually implement it. This way, it'll help those economies that are minerals rich, but perhaps capacity challenged, to be able to develop their own economies, and also to ensure that they are deemed as the preferred source within the global supply chain.